Good morning, everybody. It is Thursday, August 13th. The questions for today are, what's the hardest part about what you do? And what was your happiest moment as a child? Who were you with? Why did it make you so happy? So first question, hardest part about what I do. There's really nothing hard about my job except for dealing with different personalities as far as coworkers go. And even then, where I'm at now, it's just step one, Boo Kitty, the micromanager. But I only have today and tomorrow to deal with her, so I'll let you know if something's hard about my position in my new office. But for right now, that's all that's hard about my job. I'm grateful for that. Second question, what was my happiest moment as a child? I had a very happy childhood. The one particular moment that stands out to me is my 11th birthday. I was at McDonald's. I had my party at McDonald's, and my grandfather showed up. You have to understand, me and my grandfather are really, really close. I loved him dearly, and he didn't normally come to birthday parties and things like that. I saw him regularly, but he didn't always come to. In fact, that might have been the first birthday party of mine he came to, but I didn't know he was coming. And so we're at McDonald's and all my friends there, my mom, you know, everybody. And in comes my grandfather, and I was just so excited. All I wanted that year was a cowboy hat, which I got. And my grandfather showing up was like the icing on the cake. My father left when I was 5, and up until that point at my 11th birthday, I had not seen him since. So I was definitely a mama's girl and a granddad's girl. And my granddad was my mom's dad. So he came to my birthday party, and that just made my day. Practically any moment in my childhood that involved my grandfather or my grandmother were happy moments. My grandfather was a minister. He always taught me about the Bible, even things that might have been way above my age level, he taught me. And I find that as I grow older, those things come back to me. I may have not have known what they meant back then, or I only grasped it on a very surface level. But now that I'm older, all the things he taught me definitely come back to me. My grandmother was not as affectionate as my grandfather, but she definitely loved me, and she would always get up with me in the morning. I remember first and second grade, I used to go to school from their house. She would get up with me every morning and have Bible study with me. If that doesn't say she loved me, I don't know what else did. And she always made my favorites, grilled cheese and pancakes. She told me I was going to turn into a grilled cheese sandwich. So, yeah, those were my happiest moments. Those spent with my grandparents. I love them to death. My grandfather died the year after my 11th birthday party. He died when I was 12. So, wait a minute. Let me think about this. No, it was my 10th birthday he came to. And then he died right after my 11th birthday. See, I'm getting old. I can't remember stuff. Either way, I was very excited that he was there. And he died when I was 11. And even to this day, I'm 44 years old, and think about my grandfather every day of my life. That's how much of an impact he had on me. My grandmother lived longer. She died when I was 27. Yes, and I got to spend a lot of time with her, especially as she got older. And she had surgeries. I got to stay with her. She had a heart surgery, not heart transplant, but a bypass surgery. And I got to stay with her after her surgery for about 2 weeks in her apartment. And that was a time I'm so glad that I had with her. I'm the only grandchild out of 5 of us to really have that relationship with both of them. And I truly thank God for it, because they made me the person that I am today. So I think that's it for today. And if you are so moved, please share the video. I surely do not mind being shared across various social media outlets. So as for that, I will see you guys tomorrow, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.